Lynyrd Skynyrd, bitches. They all died in a plane crash, eh? All of them. In a plane crash. Plane crash, Sweet Home Alabama. Man, bluegrass, yo. Hey, listen, apparently country music sets more people off, as in they don't like it. You gotta love this.
If I leave here tomorrow, would you still remember me? There's too many places I've got to see.
Triple M, triple M, niggers.
And if I stay here with you, girl, things just wouldn't be the same.
Since I put a rope on this thing, it's revolutionized 3M. 3M is revolutionary. You put a rope on this thing, you'll basically get better, okay? You'll familiarize yourself with the feel of it, how the weight shift, the rope, if it's gonna burn you, where you can put it, all this kind of stuff, and your body gets stronger. Your body gets more flexible. Don't go crazy. These are 20-pound weights, okay? Each of these big weights is 10 pounds. Each of the small weights is 20 pounds. Listen, this is dedicated to my buddy, Party Cab Pete. Okay, yo, Romy, what up? Where's Pete at? Okay, so Pete, I visited him, party cabber, and I guess a fucking cocaine fiend, I gotta say. He used to blast his party cap as a pedicab. Okay, you get a couple of people, a kabuki cab, they call them in Victoria. $1 a block, or $1 a person a minute, or some crap. Basically, this is the way Pete explained it to me. You get people in the back and you're like, how much is that? $20. He got me to repeat it to him. He's like, say it again, $20. $20, just say it like it's nothing, $20. $10 doesn't cut it. You just say $20, they'll give you $10. They'll give you $5, they'll give you a toonie. They may give you $40 or $60. I've been given multiple rides with $100. The art of party cabin is you basically go out there and fucking party, and you party hard. Now, party cab Pete had fucking high-def sound system on his party cab. I don't know if you can still go to partycabbers.com or Romy. It's a great brand, man. You can do a lot with that brand, man. My buddy Romy, he basically was from Winnipeg, moved to Vancouver, sales guy essentially. He's flipping condos now, and he's basically living on an ashram in India under the tutelage of his enlightened master, Nithyananda. I encourage you to go look up the Life Bliss Foundation, guys. I seen Nithyananda. We flew out to fucking Seattle once and then Vancouver another time from Calgary, Judith and I, just to see him. Okay, so Romy, sales guy, flipping condos, he has party cabs, okay? So they used to do this in Winnipeg where he was from, okay? So he has a bunch of pedicabs. So you got like 2-seaters and then you got basically 2 to 3 people in the back, maximum 3, 2 people essentially, it's 4 couples. And then you got a bike and the guy pulling the seat. And, you know, you got all kinds of add-ons. You can have the main one would be a cover or not. You know, do you have a cover? I guess they were all covered from what I recall. But a radio, Pete had a radio. Maybe one of the other party cabs had a radio. Some of them had lights, you know. And they were all in generally tip-top condition. We used to actually store them in different places around Vancouver, like the Sheraton. We hired, or Romy talked to them and hired out some parking space under the Sheraton building right downtown. He was a great businessman, seriously. I asked him, what do you want to do? Is this all you want to do in life? And he was like, I want to do far more. So Romy, looking forward to seeing some good things, buddy. Anyway, Pete, all I wanted to say was, he used to drive around town blaring music and getting girls to fucking flash their hooters in the back of his fucking party cab, seriously. And people would roll down their windows and shout, party cabin. That's what we'd do. We'd ride up to people and be like, party cabin, party cabber. And I would just ride up to folks and I'd be like, get in. People were like, oh, okay, there's good nights and there's bad nights and I'm not feeling. No. If you're a hardcore party cabber, you get in your party cabber, you move. Romy was like, you don't stand still, you move. Okay, you move. And I used to ride up to anyone and I'd be like, get in. I just used to tell them, get in. So in sales and marketing, there's 2 things that you're balancing. Asking and telling. Asking and telling. You know what? You got to feel the vibe. If you got the power, you got to tell. If you don't have the power, you got to ask, folks. So you move around, you do your different stuff here. And that's about it, man. I've got to keep this one short, man. People look at these goddamn videos. And so, you see, here's the thing. Like, for instance, right now, instead of doing a bunch of squats, you know, I'll go down halfway. Okay, so let's just think about it. When you're doing a squat, you move through the motion, and each part of your muscle is only activated for a brief moment. This way, you're actually, oh my God, pausing along the way, and your body is eventually forcing you down. All right, so Zidey boy, appreciate you watching. Come back again, and don't unlike my videos, yo. Okay, do. Unlike them, comments appreciated. Anything that shows me that you actually got something, even if it's some kind of negativity, which essentially is your own negativity, whatever, as long as I get a reaction.